Good morning, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for your love. Good morning, people of God. Good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. Thank you for watching our videos. God bless you. Father will bless you. Authority in heaven will bless you. You are the unchangeable changer. Father, Lord, glorify yourself today. Thank you for answering our prayers, for in Jesus Christ, wonderful name we have prayed. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Once again, thank you for watching our videos. Thank you for liking us. The Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. The inexhaustible God. The inexhaustible God. Brethren, our God is inexhaustible. No one, no preacher can say, I finished preaching all the preaching, all the knowledge of God in my lifetime. Maybe probably they preach probably one-tenth or one-fifteenth in their lifetime. No businessman can say, in my entire lifetime, I've had all the monies. No lawyer can say, in my entire lifetime, I've had all the wisdom. It's inexhaustible. Psalm chapter 147, verse 5, the Bible says, great is our Lord and of great power. His understanding is infinite. His understanding is infinite. That means it cannot finish. You cannot understand everything about him. There are some things God will do in your life. You can't explain. You can't understand it. It's just like a box that you're unable to unbox. It's just like a gift that you're unable to open. You can't explain. He is so deep. He is so deep that your hand cannot reach. Eketepe shalaba. You just keep digging. You keep getting, you keep digging, you keep getting, and you cannot get to the end of it. Hallelujah. Isaiah chapter 40, verse 28. The Bible says, "Hast thou not known, hast thou not heard, that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the end, fainteth not, neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. There is no searching of his wisdom. There is no searching of his opportunity. You cannot exhaust everything on earth. There is no searching of his understanding." Brethren, part of the reason why I'm bringing this message, it amazed me the way just God opened my ears, opened my eyes to always see things from his word, to always see things from the spirit. I'm sorry to just keep saying it because it might not be new to some people, but for me, it's something like, I can't explain it and I cannot understand it because I remember when we newly started making videos, we preach once in a week, and I remember that once, like, I'm preparing the message, I get more, but these days, the more I preach it, the more I receive more, and I now realize that it's possible to even preach good messages like 3 times in a day, like, because the only thing is that you have to prepare. It's just like God giving you raw food. You know, like, it's a raw food. You have to prepare before you just show your face on the camera. From my own personal experience, I realize that even if God is giving you those things, if you don't prepare, you might not really flow. You need to prepare. You need to prepare like if you go to the Word of God, search for things and really prepare it. It's only time. Time that is not making us to have it because we still do some other things. Time, if the timing aspect is out of it, then we should be able to be doing such. God is so inexhaustible. Many, many melodies in the spirit, many songs, even as a songwriter. You cannot say that you have finished all the melodies in the spirit. It's not possible. Even what are we saying? Our God is infinite. There is no searching of his understanding. There is nothing he cannot do. So what is the essence of this message? When you understand that it's infinite, when you understand that it's so much big, you need to picture big things for your life. Picture big future. Imagine great things for your life. Don't think low of yourself. Don't say you cannot do it. You can do it. You can do it. You can do it more than you think. Because the God you serve is inexhaustible. There is no searching of his understanding. He is so deep that you cannot exhaust it. That you cannot exhaust all the benefits. You cannot exhaust all the opportunities in your lifetime. No one can exhaust it. I heard a pastor preaching like 2 years ago. I heard him preaching, he said, He said one of his church member or maybe his worker told him that, "Pastor, I'm afraid that like after some time you don't have what to preach again." And the pastor said, he told that church member that, "Leave your fear." Let me tell you, the pastor is actually correct. It's not possible. It's not possible. So picture good future for yourself. Picture big thing for yourself. Picture great opportunities for yourself, because the God you serve has it. Amen. The Lord will help us in the name of Jesus. So how can you assess these things, these great things, this mystery, these big things, big opportunity from God? Brethren, the Bible says in Zechariah chapter 4 verse 6, it says, "Not by power, not by might, but by my spirit, says the Lord." You can only assess all these things by the spirit, by the power of the Lord that is in you, that is upon you, in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in 2 Corinthians 3:17, it says, "Now the Lord is that spirit." The spirit of God in you, it is the Lord himself. It is a power in you. It is a mystery in you. Oh, my shaker. It is like an engine in you. It is like a possibility that God has deposited in you. It is like a possibility that the Lord has deposited in the world, in you, around you, upon you, in your heart. It's a grace. It's an empowerment. It's an enablement in the name of Jesus. Number two, you have to fear God. The Bible says the secret of the Lord dwells with them that fear him. When you fear God, when you trust God, when you fear him, he will reveal things, he will reveal mysteries to you. I pray the Lord God will help us in the name of Jesus. How can you assess this mystery and benefit again? You have to open up your spirit. Open up yourself unto him, like somebody that wants to receive. At least somebody that wants to receive a gift will be expectant. You want to receive a congratulation, you want to receive an employment offer or something. You have to open up your heart. Position yourself well to receive from him. Make room for him. Make up time for him. If it's mystery, if it's songs or spiritual things you want to receive, you have to place your ears close to his heart. Place your ears close to him. Like, was it 2 weeks ago? Somebody, they were asking me from my place of work. One person asked me, he said, you don't talk too much. I don't know what the way he put it. I said, usually everybody should not talk too much. But even by the virtue of the fact that I preach, that one is even enough for me not to talk too much. We made a video on refraining your lips. I said, because I need to open up my mind. I need to receive more. I need to give my ears. I said, everyone should not talk too much. The Bible says, in the multitude of words, there flutters sin. But then even as a preacher, no, you see, your own has to be, you don't have to talk. Another person asked me, said, because usually I talk, I say, "Oh, why are you calm?" I said, "No, I don't even like to talk too much because I need to open up my spirit." So you need to open up yourself to receive from him. I pray the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. The God we are served, we are serving is so big, is so big, so great, in the name of Jesus. So let me tell you, indeed, there is nothing he cannot do. You know, the Bible says with God, all things are possible. Mashallah. The Bible says with him, all things are possible. It is true. If you are trusting God for something, you are expecting him for something, you have prayed, you have trusted him, you are expectant, you have done all, you have practiced all the principle behind what you are expecting, that you are afraid in the word of God, and it's not yet coming, it seems it's not coming. Number one, possibly it could be that God has better things for you. One. Two, it could be timing. You know, there is time for everything under the heart. It could be that God is keeping it to the right time. It could be that it is not his will. For instance, as a child, a very small child asking God for a car. It might not be God's will for him or her to drive at the age of probably 7 or 8. If you have done everything, you are not in sin, you have feared God, you have practiced all the principle, and it seems that it's not coming, brethren, don't worry. It will all turn to be your good. Indeed, there is nothing he cannot do. There is no searching of his understanding. He is inexhaustible. He is powerful. You cannot exhaust him. It's not possible. So deep, everything you have, you are in need of. Everything you are in need of. Everything you are trusting him for. He has everything. He has everything in his heart. The Bible says he's infinite. His understanding is infinite. There is no searching of his understanding. Makataba shalaba. Inde kekeke lebetekebe. Oh my God. Arapotekebe shalaba. And now stand on the rock of ages, which is living Jesus Christ. Whatever be your expectation, whatever be your heart desire, I pray the Lord grant it unto you in the name of Jesus. No more delay. According to his great power, by the mercy of the Lord, receive it in the name of Jesus. Whatever be your expectation, whatever be your heart desire in your life, in your family, in your career, in your ministry, in your assignments, in your environment, in your country. Oh, ripoto kopo shalaba. The Lord said, we should ask, it shall be given. We should seek, it shall be found. We should knock, it shall be opened. Whatever be your expectation, whatever be your heart desire, receive it by mercy. Receive it by the hand of the Lord in the name of Jesus. Ebe shekete likataya balaba. Oh my God, so shall it be in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Father, we give you praise. We honor you. We reference you. Oh, we bless your name. Glory, glory to your name in the name of Jesus. For in Jesus Christ's wonderful name we have prayed. Amen. Thank you for watching. If you are watching me, you are still living in sin. You are here to confess Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior. And you would like to do so. Can you please say this prayer after me? Say, Lord Jesus, thank you for dying for my sins. Thank you for sending your word unto me today. Father, please forgive me my sins. Come into my life. Come and be the Lord of my life. Thank you for answering my prayers. For in Jesus Christ's wonderful name we have prayed. Amen. God bless you. Thank you for watching. Please, I want you to give this video a thumbs up. Share with somebody. We appreciate your likes, your share, your comments. And it shall be well with you as you are doing so. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you, lift up his countenance upon you, and give you peace in the name of Jesus. Thank you for watching. I love you. And I will see you next time. Bye.